Last time we talked about Steven Universe, we closed out the summer of Steven Universe with the show's most powerful character, Corrupted Steven. Now it's time to turn the clock back 7 years to the second episode of Steven Universe as we cover the Laser Light Cannon to see just how much power it would have to pack. For the purposes of this analysis, we will be isolating the weapon's debut episode as its only evidence of power, as its later uses don't show any growth in power. With that in mind, let's strap in! We all know that the heights of Steven Universe characters fluctuate all the time, but lo and behold, me from a year ago when I wrote this script forgot that. Apparently past me said,
"Yeah, we'll use this waffle iron, it will scale the waffle iron to his head, and scale his head to the van."
But luckily, Honor, have revised that script. And we'll just be using Greg's van normally, since it is apparently a 70s Dodge Tradesman. For today's purposes, we will be using the dimensions of a 1974, because that was a good year. With that detail in mind, we can determine the eyeball's total volume, which works out to a whopping 14,914.40. Based on the eyeball's color and design, let's assume it's constructed out of ruby. Using the tensile strength of rubies, 325 megapascals, dividing the total volume by the radius of the eyeball, 15.27 meters, then multiplying that area by the aforementioned tensile strength before multiplying all of that by the blast radius of the explosion, which is 57.4 meters, we can finally calculate the laser light cannon to be able to produce the energy equivalent of 18,220,540,000,000 joules, aka 4,354.8 tons of TNT. And there you have it. With over 4,000 tons of TNT behind it, the laser light cannon has to be one of the most deadly weapons in the world of Steven Universe. That is if you exclude all the characters. But who's counting, you know? Not me. Hey guys, Honor here. Just wanted to say, if you enjoyed these last three videos, the Godzilla, Doctor Strange, and of course this video, where I cover just one feat instead of a whole character's history of feats, maybe I'll turn this into a series where it'll be an episode featuring three or four feats of different characters. And if you have any suggestions, put them down below. And of course, if you like this, be sure to hit that like and subscribe button, and I'll see you next week.